the one and only Al Jarreau, tonight on Felicia. Everything it brings,
it brings. Al Jarreau in the house.
The magic of Al Jarreau and the finalists in the Old Mutual Jazz Encounters in a musical extravaganza.
Thank you. Oh my God, Al Jarreau in the house. Welcome, welcome. It's a holiday musical fest for you tonight. Five-time Grammy Award winner Al Jarreau is right here in studio. Back in South Africa, he is joined by some of South Africa's sultry singers, some of South Africa's upcoming talent as well. The list goes on and on when it comes to Al Jarreau. Songs, Spain, Morning, Boogie Down, Moonlighting, yeah? The theme to Moonlighting, what's the one I love the best? We in this love together. Da, 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 da. Oh my gosh! There are so many of these tunes, you know them. Oh, South Africa. But what I like about Al, he said, I know many South Africans cannot afford to come to the show, but I want to come into studio and share my music with them because they buy the CDs here in South Africa. So thanks, South Africa. Now, let's give Al Jarreau a warm South African Ubuntu welcome. Al, please go ahead. Hi.
Oh, my.
Well, we're in this
love together. Yes, yeah. We are.
Thank you.
Well, thanks, Al. Have a seat. We're going to do something quite interesting right now.
Uh-oh.
Wait a minute. You know, I'm not going to have an interview with you. We're going to have a conversation, and I'm taking you down memory lane. I hope this is going to work, because if it does not, I'm going to die.
Please don't let it be my old girlfriend.
Oh! Hold on. We're going to try something because you don't know who I am. You're going to know after this.
Hello.
Hold a minute. Guess who I have here in studio? Al Jarreau. Hold on one second. Hold on.
Mr. President?
Hi, Al. It's a singing psychologist.
who is this?
Earl Suttle from Lincoln High School in Milwaukee.
Earl Suttle.
Remember Sharon Seventh-day Church?
From high school and from Sharon Chapel Seventh-day Adventist Church. My heaven. Oh, it's such a small world. Where are you now?
I'm in Atlanta, Georgia.
You're in Atlanta? Boy, she made that call really fast. Oh, Earl, this is so unbelievably wonderful.
We always used to admire you when you were singing in church.
Jesus wants me for a sunbeam.
We always said, someday, Al, you're going to be famous.
Oh, Earl, you sound so good. I love this.
What do you think about South Africa?
I love South Africa. What a small world, huh? What a small
Well, he better
world.
Get
Amazing.
Off the phone now.
Okay.
Felicia
says we have to stop so I can sing some music and we're gonna talk some too. God bless your heart. Thank you. I'll see you back there in Atlanta. I'm there often.
Yes. Okay.
Okay. Bye bye.
You were just thinking. Thanks. Oh, what a surprise. He woke you up, huh? Okay. Talk to you then. That's what I like about Vodacom. Got it. Just like that. Guess what? That's what I said. We're not having an interview. This is a conversation. Lincoln High School.
Lincoln High School, Marquette University.
That's right. That's where I went. Uh-huh.
There are not many people in the United States who went to Marquette University. Mm-hmm. How amazing that you, a South African, came to America and went to school at Marquette in Milwaukee, where I grew up.
And your father was the minister at Sharon Seventh-day Adventist, and
yes.
Your mom the pianist.
And my mom was the pianist, yes.
And you, you had a trio there, Dallas and, is it?
And Qdalius.
Qdalius.
And Qdalius. I can't believe Earl remembers that stuff.
He remembers all this stuff. Ah. And you sang in school with the Lincoln Follies, huh?
Oh, yeah. Uh-huh. It was a big variety show every year, and everybody sang and danced and played instruments and did music. It was with the a cappella and the band. It was a wonderful performance that the whole community looked forward to, and people came from everywhere to that program because there were really some talented people at Lincoln High School.
You were a basketball player as well, I hear, and a baseball player.
Yeah, I played basketball and baseball.
Your brother, Marshall, was a baseball player.
Right, and I ran cross country.
Excuse me.
I'm still running.
Oh, and your brother Marshall was there.
And Marshall was there too?
Because he was in
Marshall
class
was Marshall and his teammates waited till I left too, and they won the state championship as cross country runners, but they waited till I left.
And your older brother apparently also sang very well.
Two older brothers who sang very well, Emil and Alpheus, yes.
Uh-huh.
Yes. And we did family recitals that were fundraisers for the church.
God, what
so, family. Yeah, down memory lane.
And then you went
South
to
Africa.
Yeah, I know.
That's amazing.
Went to Ripon College.
People don't know about this in America. They don't.
We do research here, you know.
You sure do.
And then you went to Ripon College.
Ripon College, small liberal arts school. Uh-huh. We were 800 students. Most high schools are bigger than that. They've grown now. It's 900 students.
And
I was classmates with Harrison Ford. Yeah, Harrison Ford was a classmate of mine.
Called you the singing psychologist, huh?
Well, they did, but that was not true. You know, I studied psychology, but you know, advertisers like to make mountains of molehills. And so they called me the singing psychologist, and I sang a lot in Milwaukee. That's where it got started for me.
I think folks at home are saying, can he sing now? But I just thought you should hear about this man's warm, sentimental background. Because everybody asks you the tough questions about the Grammys and all of this. But when I was talking to Earl and he said, guess what? He was in school with Duke. Remember, Duke was a coach with Earl at North Division High School. Wellington Warren, I think.
Yeah, Wellington Warren. Yeah. That's right. WW. We called him Duke. WW. Wellington Warren. I mean, what a name for a little black kid. Wellington. Wellington Warren.
Well, Al Jarreau was in South Africa on tour, and he was performing at the Old Mutual Jazz Encounters Talent Search. Guess what? He's not just going to talk here. He is going to sing us three songs, not one. Three! Al Jarreau said, Penny, what did Al say when he said he was going to sing three songs?
He said he can't wait to sing the three songs.
Because
I didn't even have
he's
to
never sang
his
so many songs.
He? No, he
that's
didn't.
Right.
He said,
I've never
what?
Sung so many songs on TV. Normally, they let you sing one song, and then it's short, the short version of it, and you stop. So, very unusual
if
situation.
If I did that, Hopkins would kill me. So anyway, Moonlighting. Let's hear it. Moonlighting.
Thank you. Just a stranger, love the blue. the way.
Sybil Shepherd and Bruce Willis. It was Bruce's first show, you know.
Uh-huh.
Yes. And when the writer of that song asked me to do the lyric for it and perform it, he was talking to me on the telephone and he said, it's a new show that's going to pilot. We don't know if it's going to go, but we'll try it in the fall. It's starring Sybil Shepherd. And then I hear these papers rattling because he's looking for this guy's name that's starring with Sybil Shepherd. And he's looking for it. And he said, yes, yeah, Bruce Willis.
Oh, my God.
Who knew?
He was going to be big time. Maybe. Sybil had some legs, though. She had some legs.
Oh, yeah.
Tina Turner kind of legs.
We'll talk about that, yeah. They never invited me on the show.
More after the break. Trust me, we're going to try and have him sing all your favorites. I'm joking.
Another hit from Al in a moment.
When they come to concert, they think, insane.
Do you suffer from a birth disfigurement? Do you look different because of the way that you were born, and because of it, your life has become a living hell? Do you suffer from progeria, neonatal progeria, or perhaps Mellnik needle syndrome? If so, this is your chance to speak out. Call Felician E now.
Sexy rhythms of Latin American.
Latino dancing, and we consult the charts to see what the new year holds in store.
I think that there is lots of growth and expansion going their way.
Welcome back. We are just trying to spice up your holidays. We are joined in studio by a man who was voted the most smooth jazz vocalist of the year 2001. I mean, Al Jarreau.
Smooth. What a bunch of baloney, huh? What a bunch of phony baloney. Smooth.
5 Grammys.
Where do you come?
That's understandable.
Well,
5 Grammys.
People who've seen me in concert, they don't think smooth. When they come to concert, they think insane. Crazy.
But that's passion.
Yeah.
That's why you won 5 Grammy Awards. Yeah, started performing at a small jazz club with a trio headed by George Duke.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, boy.
Yes, now that was San Francisco. When I left Ripon College, I did a program in counseling at the University of Iowa, and then I went to San Francisco so that I could be a social worker by day and sing at night. And George Duke and I were really children. Mm. I mean, we were really kids, 20, 24 or 25 years old, like that, and I think George was 21 or 22. And we were doing music in San Francisco during the heyday, the golden era of rock and roll. I mean, that was the time when Janis Joplin and Grateful Dead and Jefferson Airplane and all those groups were emerging. Mm-hmm. Sly Stone, out of San Francisco. Mm-hmm. Haight Ashbury was just on fire. And we were doing this jazzy music, and people were coming to hear it.
America, September 11th. A quote here, you said, it was a wake-up call for us.
Yeah.
It's important for America to be wise in seeking the terrorists. We should think what they are angry about.
Yeah.
We need to examine why they are terrorists, why they have such anger, and maybe then we'll be able to do something about it. In short, I think you're saying it's communication that helps.
I'm also saying, you know, America, look, take the mirror and look at it and find out if you have done some things in the past that have made people so very, very angry. Mm-hmm. What have been our policies in that region of the world for 50 years? And we need to examine that. And if we find some things that we need to fix, get about fixing them. And in the meantime, take some bread there, build some schools. And Colin Powell suggested that we do that, that we go there with medicines and with food and with bread and educational programs and really be a help.
As you're visiting South Africa, what do you think South Africa can teach America?
Oh, the world, my darling. This has been a classroom for the last 15, 20 years that the world is having a look at, and you're getting great grades, The new South Africa integrated and cooperating with one another and open and inclusive. Mm-hmm. That's what I love. Inclusive. You're teaching the world, not just America.
Well, as you say, I'm looking forward to being educated about what is going on in music in South Africa. Guess what you have tonight? Brilliant young ladies who are also going to serenade you out. Going to serenade you.
I'm ready.
Oh, yeah.
Serenade me.
But before they serenade you, the audience would like to hear another song.
Okay.
Just to be loved.
I love it.
All right. Rock and roll.
You made me something like I
Unbelievable.
Thank you, Felicia.
The singing psychologist. After the break, more with Elle, but some of South Africa's ladies of jazz are coming to celebrate this young man. And we say happy holidays. I hope you're enjoying your holidays.
Happy holidays.
Yeah, I know.
Are you a woman who has been raped or brutally abused? Were you infected with the AIDS virus because of being raped? This is your opportunity to speak out and make a difference. So call now.
Well, we are celebrating the holidays. You've just heard Elle Giroux. What a voice. Give him a hand again. 5 Grammys. Elle Giroux, previous winner of the Old Mutual Jazz Encounters, was our own Judith Sipuma, presently performing at Back of the Moon. Elle, this girl happens to be one of your greatest fans. Her dream is to one day sing with you.
Oh, that could happen.
Judith has just released a new CD, and she's going to perform one of the tracks, and it is called A Cry, A Smile, and A Dance. Wanted to ask Elle?
I just want to ask him one thing. How do you do that? How do you do that?
Can we sing together? Would you start up that music from anywhere down toward the end, maybe the last half minute? And we'll just I follow you, you know, I'll follow you, and I won't get in the way, I promise. I know how to sing background. Yeah.
I'm taking over, huh?
Beautiful. Thanks, Al. Making one young woman's dream a reality. Thank you.
You can't pass these moments sometimes. It's happening now. Let's do it now.
Yeah. Well, after the break, another young musician, Nombulelo.
Send your topic suggestions to Felicia on E at FMS Productions, PO Box 29896, Melville 2109, or by email to Felicia at etv.co.za. Join us in studio free of charge when we record Felicia on E, 476-8411 or 2. Call now.
Happy holidays. We are having fun here in studio, and as I said, we have four beautiful jazz singers, ladies, who are coming to serenade Al Jarreau.
Yay.
Yeah. This young lady you're going to hear now has been, says, one of her role models in music is Leta Mbuli. Leta Mbuli. And she's going to sing a South African song. She's going to make jazz it up like we do in South Africa. Remember Miriam Makeba was obviously one of the hottest.
Of course.
And Miriam's...
Leta Mbuli too. Yes. Yes.
Okay, let's hear Nombulelo, who is also one of the finalists for the All Mutual Jazz Encounters. Nombulelo.
Thank you.
Well, that was the lovely Nombulelo. You know one thing you do? You make everyone feel at home. There's something about you. Actualized men, I guess.
Takes one to know one. And I think it's important, you know, to make people feel like,
I know. But honestly and truly, you have these American stars. They come here and make you feel so uncomfortable. They think they're something. But you are something.
Those are the young guys, you know.
No.
Young some guys.
Even
somehow,
the older ones.
Yeah, but still young. Mm-hmm. Still young. That's a child, you know, who comes with all that attitude, you know.
I respect you. I respect you for that. But one of the hottest rising stars in jazz is Melanie Scholes.
So vast is the sky, with faraway clouds just wandering by. Where do they go? Oh, I don't know. Don't know.
Give Al a hug first.
Oh, please.
Oh,
you wonderful. Oh, thank you. You're like my hero.
Oh. Would you sing just that little piece again from the that little opera piece that you did before? Just a little piece again.
The one you did during the break.
It was so beautiful. Go
ahead.
Yeah.
Natalie. who gets down.
You're thrilling me here. You're thrilling me here.
Boogie down.
Wow, wonderful.
What you want? What is
it? I can't be what I want to, and all I need is to get my boogie down.
That's what she's gonna do. That's what Natalie's gonna do after the break.
All right.
After you watch Natalie, let us know which Old Mutual Jazz Encounter finalist you think shows the most promise. Natalie, Melanie, or Nombulelo. Your call counts. Call now.
Sexy rhythms of Latin America.
Latino dancing, and we consult the charts to see what the new year holds in store.
I think that there is lots of growth and expansion going their way.
I really appreciate you coming. I think more important, I just appreciate the fact that you came and sang so many songs already. So if you did not go to the show, you got a good feel of the of what happened at Sandton Convention Center. Well, all the way from Durban is the national finalist. Her name is Natalie Rangan, and she currently sings, writes, and arranges her music with her five-piece band, Swing Theory, while studying towards the completion of her master's degree.
Thanks, Natalie. Did you write that song as well, Mary?
Yeah, she wrote
you
that
wrote
one.
You wrote it, arranged it as well?
Yeah. Yes, I did.
You are talented.
Great.
Oh, well, thanks.
Can you tell us about these young ladies?
Felicia, they're all part of the Old Mutual Jazz Competition. We've got so much talent in South Africa, and the competition is about unearthing that talent, sort of finding people, helping them realize their potential, and allowing them to sing alongside. I mean, I think we're so lucky this year to have El Giro. Mm-hmm. And I think for the singers themselves, it's such a fantastic opportunity.
Well, I want to hear from Penny how Al's tour has been.
Felicia, it's been the most marvelous tour of the country. Al has played 3 shows in South Africa. He's done 2 sell-out concerts in Johannesburg and Cape Town. So Al's played to over 20,000 people in a week in the country.
Wow.
Yeah.
El Giro! South Africa loves Al. You know. And you were at Chastain Park in Atlanta not long ago.
But I'll tell you, in
all fairness, I think we gave you a better welcome than any place
in the world. No doubt. It's really the truth.
And you were involved with Operation Hunger.
Yes, that was last time that I was involved with Operation Hunger, and I'm not sure if that program is still going just these days.
In fact, Zindzi Mandela said I should say hello
to you. Oh, wonderful. Mm-hmm. My regards to her, too. Mm-hmm. So this time, you know, we weren't asked to really help in that way, so we decided that we would do some things with some young musicians and young professionals doing roadie work, and so we're going to meet with them, me and the band and I, and see what, answer some questions.
You are unbelievable. That's all I can say. I do not have the right words. Unbelievable. 5 words.
5 words. I like that. Yeah.
Well, El Giro, we'd like to thank you for exhibiting what we in South Africa call Ubuntu. Humanity, warmth, yeah. Aww. You're real.
Thank you.
Yeah. Am I right?
Thank you.
Well, you know, we're going into the holidays, and this is our last show for 2001, and that's why we're so excited that you came to studio. We will return on January the 8th with a Latin American spectacular. I wish you were here to see how these girls dance. Well, thanks for watching, and I hope you're enjoying your holidays, or you're going to enjoy your holidays, I should say. Which one are you going to sing for us now?
Let's do Zany Bon Bon Bon. That means Zany Bon Bon Go Watson.
Oh, yes, that's what we're going to hear.
Roof Garden.
Roof Garden, all right. Until next year, goodbye.
Thank you.
That's it, baby. Say, girl, what is your mama gonna say when she find out that you party like this? She say, boom, boom. Hey, anyone wanna go dance upon the roof? Baby, do you know? Anyone wanna go?
Felicia on E would like to take this opportunity to wish you a peaceful and safe festive season. We'll be back on January the 8th, 2002 with Latino. Join Felicia online at www.feliciaonline.co.za to find out all about Felicia Mabuza Subtle, the motivator, the mother, and the talk show host. Read her empowering column Heart to Heart every Tuesday in Sowetan and her motivational column in Motivation of Champions magazine.